Why would game show contestants be willing to give each other painful and potentially deadly electric shocks? Well, they say the power of television made them do it. The whole thing was part of an experiment shown in a French documentary called The Game of Death, where contestants believed they were giving dangerous electric shocks to other players. Well, actually, those victims were actors. But the disturbing results were all too real, and Randy Kay is here with this story. Ugh.
Yeah, I know.
It gives me the creeps.
It makes you a little queasy just watching it. But as Campbell said, it's called The Game of Death, a French game show that's part of a documentary on French TV to expose what the show's creators call, quote, TV's mind-numbing power to suspend morality and the striking human willingness to obey orders. Now, here's how the game show works. Contestants pose a question. If their fellow player gets the answer wrong, he is zapped with as much as 460 volts of electricity. And the contestants can keep upping that voltage. Now, even though the players appear to be writhing in pain, audience members cheer them on, shouting for more punishment. Some players were reluctant, but most eventually give in. In fact, just 16 out of the 80 back down. The rest are swayed by the audience and the show's host. Now, it turns out all of this is fake. There isn't really an electric current flowing through those wires, and the players who look like they're being tortured are actors, actually, hired to play this part. Their agony, Campbell, all just part of the show.
So why would they do a thing like that?
Well, that's what we wanted to know, and it is all part of this documentary airing on French TV tonight, which looks at the power of persuasion and social behavior. The producers say it proves that people are willing to act against their own morals, their own principles, when they're ordered to do something extreme by a source that they trust is legitimate. In this case, the audience, and of course the show's very glamorous host. We asked a professor of psychology at Santa Clara who studies social behavior to weigh in on all of this.
They're in a situation where they have to act quickly. They can't stop and think about what is the right thing to do. They have to act right now. All of those things lead people to respond to the situational cues. Everybody is torn. Nobody in the original experiment or in this study, I'm sure, thought that this was a lot of fun or something they enjoy doing. But they could not find a way to stop themselves from going along with it.
Now, the blind obedience in this case is being compared to the behavior of German soldiers ordered to commit atrocities inside Nazi concentration camps. But the show's whole premise is based on an experiment, actually, from the 1960s at Yale. In that case, a similar method of shocking or fake shocking was used to show the power of authority and obedience. In that case, 65% of the participants chose to go with the maximum electrical shock available, which was 400 volts.
I can't, this just really...
It really says something about people, doesn't it?
What's the lesson here?
The lesson is that even the most well-adjusted person can be swayed to act in horrendous ways if the situation leads them to it. That anyone is vulnerable to this.
Oh, I hope that's not the case. Randy Kay, it's fascinating. Really, really curious to see that documentary. Thanks for being here.
Sure.
Appreciate it.